This is your weekly trip to paradise, Louisiana style, with Gary Risponi. Paradise, Louisiana is brought to you by Circle K, Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change, Demco, CCA Louisiana, and the CCA Louisiana Star Tournament, Relief Windows, Visit Baton Rouge, an authentic Louisiana experience, and by Farm Bureau Insurance.
Go Tigers. Ain't no more Go Tigers. Just watch them Tigers. You'll never see another one like it. Never see a season like that. You might see a better team one of these days. They might have had a better team. But you'll never see a season like the Tigers. Coach O and all your crew, God bless you. God bless Louisiana with a good one. So can't have everything. We have a bad duck season so far. Man, you know, that hurt. Football's been great. Saints, 1 out of 3. We ain't so bad. Stay tuned, because we got a little story with this. Perry Barras has been sending me a lot of reports. Down south, fishing adventures. Let me tell you what. This young man really knows that Pontchartrain Basin. We had some revelers that came down from Tennessee. My friend Tim Romero and his boy, and his daughter's boyfriend. And Tim sort of partied a little bit too much. And we did a lot of running. We were looking for bass and redfish. And Perry was trying to please me. When we finally got on him, we had to come back. So here's a little story. This is going to be the main show today. Perry Bass fishing the Pontchartrain Basin. I'm talking about from Mr. Goldblum to Mort. We ran everywhere. And here's how he looked for bass. So then... we have time, we're going to visit Chaz again at Dockside TV this time of year. He always knows where to go and how to do it. So, and I have a short speckerbelly video that I took in Irwinville with my friend Wayne Amato and Ralph Campanile. Well, let me tell you, to know that speckerbelly is this close in the rice fields, but it's still like any goose, they're hard to get around there. We made one kill, I think I got it on video. We're going to show you that. The last thing, we got the fishing and hunting report. And we got a few deer kills. We got a bunch of tournament reports coming, especially Southwest Junior Bassmasters. Stay tuned for Paradise, Louisiana. One more time. Thank you, Lord. What a great team. Go Tigers.
Introducing Powerade Ion 4, complete with 4 electrolytes lost in sweat. Powerade Ion 4, the complete sports drink.
Fishing. It's where good stories come from. It's about good times and family and friends. It's about taking a couple home for dinner tonight and saving a few for tomorrow. It's all about that and so much more. To CCA, fishing is about enjoying today and making sure tomorrow is even better. To us, fishing comes with a responsibility for the resources we enjoy so much. If fishing means all that to you, then you belong with CCA.
Paradise, Louisiana. This has been 7 or 8 years in the making. Captain Perry Barras, and like they say in Lafayette, Barra.
That's right.
That's the way
you
do it?
Yeah. A lot of people pronounce it Barras because of the way it's spelled, but it's actually French. And it's called Barra.
Keep talking. There's a camera right there, and I want you to sit so they can hear you. We got a little wind, we're getting ready to go. So this is 7 years in the making. This boy's been sending me, this man's been sending me reports, been sending me pictures of bass and everything out of Bienvenue. You've been catching fish for the last 2 weeks, right there at your house, catching bass and redfish, and somewhere over here.
What are we doing today? Tell us what we're going to set it up. We're getting ready to do.
Well, we're actually going to try to fish these points right here and try to catch some bass and some redfish. If we don't catch anything here, if the water's not too dirty, then we're going to move on to Mr. Go, and we may hit a couple of pockets over there off Mr. Go, and then we're going to try to hit Camp Bayou. This guy right here likes to catch bass, so I want to put this guy on some bass.
I like to catch anything, but to them would be a lot on camera. See that bait right there? That's a Magneta, right?
That's right.
That's Chaz's bait.
That's Chaz.
Matrix Chaz.
That's Champagne, that's right.
I had a bunch. I didn't bring them. We went to Island Marina this morning. We got enough of them, I'm sure.
Yeah.
These guys right here, we got spinning rods. We're going to catch some. No cork. We even got a few shrimp. But we
got
to get them.
We got some live shrimp from Miss Angie at.
Call it Farm Bureau Insurance.
That's right. That's right. You always got to carry some insurance.
You got a lot of sponsors to help him. Your boat comes from Tim?
Tim's Marine. Tim's Marine. Good people out there.
We ain't going to run a commercial today, but we want to introduce you to him. You're going to be selling a lot more of him on Paradise, Louisiana, I hope, if I don't black out him. Y'all stay tuned. You're watching Paradise, Louisiana. Right now, I see the Great Wall. I see Bayou Avenue. I think the gates open. Stay tuned. Let's see what we're going to put the pressure on him. That's what kind we want. He's a keeper. He ain't that big. Hold him toward the camera. Right here. That's a keeper. Put him in the box.
That's
a fillet. See the bait.
Get that cork, look.
Lay it out in front. Tell me about this pattern y'all been on. You've been on for years like this, but where are we fishing? And tell me about the pattern.
It's Camp Bayou. It's off Mr. Go. This time of the year, the bass move in here pretty thick. And this is actually about a 12-foot, there's another bite right there. It's about a 12-foot canal. And where they're fishing at right there is about 2 feet. And all this runs through here and it's Mr. Go.
Okay,
this canal goes out to Lake Bourne. So it's just a big, just goes in the,
And they got depots they can get out of, right?
Yeah, yeah, when it gets cold like this.
Oh, found that. Look at him, Rudolph. Did Perry find him? It took a little while, but he found a fish. Uh-oh, come on. There you go, Perry. Ain't no keeper, but he's there. Same type of bait, a little bit different color. There he is. Anchovy. Fish on.
Fish on.
The depot, right out there in the middle. Ooh, good fish. That's what I'm looking for. Talk to me, Fair. Look at that.
That's a beautiful, maybe 2-pound bass right there.
Push him out. Same green trout. There it is. Live shrimp. He's a little one. There ain't nothing. Now, Perry's on camera. Perry, tell me. Where them big fish you were catching?
I can't show you that one. I told you I'd take your bass fishing, not going to a tournament.
Yeah, hog fishing. Yeah, starting this way. Hey, little bear. That's a fillet. Hold it toward the camera like this. Let me see what he got.
Hey, just
that
nice little bass.
That's a fillet. That's a fillet. That way it's caught.
Well, clear baits are always my go-to, because there's a lot of glass minnows and shrimp, and this bait, this color right here resembles that. I usually use a 3/8 jig head, and when I'm fishing over grass, the water's high right now, so I can fish over grass.
Yeah. Look. Live shrimp. In front of Ralph Campanile's pier. Oh, what? It's live. Look, see the camp? Mike DeVincenti. Kirk was on his pier.
There's no better way to cool down this summer than with a delicious, thirst-quenching Polar Pop Cup from Circle K. The Polar Pop Cup is the coolest way to beat the heat. Fill your Polar Pop Cup up with the flavors you crave and crushed or cubed ice. Nothing stays cold longer, so you can stay refreshed all day long. Stop in Circle K today for an ice-cold Polar Pop Cup. Polar Pop Cup, only at Circle K. Take it easy.
I've been asking him to change the oil for months now, and he never did, so I finally just went to Benny's. They even washed my car for free. Uh-huh. And you know what? It was amazing. Yeah, I left Benny's and got home before Rob even knew I was gone.
Benny? Who the heck is Benny?
Hey, welcome back to Paradise, to Louisiana. Look where we at. BB guys, BBQ guys, look at this. All the ovens and grills and everything you got, we're going to be showing you more and more of that while we're going on. We're probably going to do a little cooking here, and it won't be long. But let me tell you right now, if you want to cook deer and you want to try some wild game, you want to be what we call from the field to the grill, this is the place you come. But let me give you some deer reports right now coming out. Braden Nuccio is a 9-year-old boy from the New Orleans area. He's at an 8-point. His first deer, he was hunting in Alabama. He was hunting with Ryan Sinopoli and them. By the way, Braden is the grandson of the parish president of St. Bernard. Guy McInnes, y'all might have saw him on the mother shows. He catching redfish and speckled trout too. He's an all-around outdoorsman. Congratulations. I want to thank Paul for sending me that. Tracy Howard, it's a young lady. We was over there in Irvinville. This lady and her friend, they were sitting in there and they recognized us when we were talking about hunting. This is an outdoor lady. She hunts with her boyfriend, but she don't need her boyfriend to go with her. Here's a 5-point, an old 5-point, 25-inch spread. Look at his spread. But had very few teeth, so you know how old he was. That's a bow kill. She also had a 10-point she bow killed. She was hunting in Bossier Parish. Then this is 10-year-old Brooks Hebert. That's Mark Mahai's grandson. It did his first deer at St. Francisville. Beautiful deer. Killed it with his gun. Killed it with his rifle for Christmas rifle. So now, there's some other deer. I have some people coming in with deer. So be sure and send them in, especially those record deer y'all got. If y'all put them in the contest, we might be bringing you more from Bowie Outfitters. And if they're going to give us some pictures. So later on, we do that before the season ends. St. Francisville, I tell you, in those areas, the rut is on, so I know a lot of people have been killing. My son and them have been killing them up in Mississippi right now. Bobby Black and them up there, they were hanging deer when we went up there duck hunting, and duck hunting sucks. I'm going to tell you what, it has been great up there, but all that rain came there. We went all the way up there. We decided not to hunt Sunday, because my friends Wayne and them are getting ready to go to Kentucky. Wayne and his son, and they got an invitation, so we didn't waste that. I came back and I stayed home Sunday, but my lease in Delacroix didn't make a hunt. First it had water hyacinths, then it didn't have any water. So let me give you a duck report. I'm gonna show you a little video later on about with Ralph Campanile and Wayne with them speckle bellies over there at Harlan Cashiola's place over there across the river. By the way, Wayne is one of the best callers around, and my buddy Ralph Campanile, probably one of the better shots around. He was shooting a 10 gauge, by the way, too. He says it makes a difference, so I don't know. We got some reports from Central Part of the State, Andrew Morley and Grady Bates. They're hunting up there, and mostly till Saturday with all the rain. I was in the rain, I'm gonna tell you, pouring down. They had till, mostly till, and it was warm and hot. Now, Sunday, Lynn Rollins, our cohort, and my hero, Lynn Rollins and Grady Bates, they were hunting up there, thanks to Brent, his brother, Sunday was cold and sunshine, and look at these. Had a smorgasbord they had, I called it. Gadwalls, pintails, mallards, widgeons, every kind of duck you can imagine. They had a good hunt, and they still got another week, so good luck. Here's a picture of Steve McAllister. I don't know if I showed it last week, but in his dog Breeze, and this another one come from Central Park. And then again, I tell you, Delacroix was bad. It was bad. The reports I got up in Whiteville, my grandson up there with his in-laws, they had a bad hunt Saturday. I didn't talk to them Sunday, but that warm weather didn't do good. They had one duck when he texted me. I told you, most of my buddies and them are heading to Kentucky and heading up to Nebraska, and we'll talk about it. But I got a few more. Now, you know, these are running all next week. I didn't get a report from Top Gun, but I'm sure that front, and with all that rain, it was bad. We didn't see a whole lot of ducks flying. Now, we were coming out in the agriculture fields. They weren't in the woods. We saw them getting up. Same story I heard now from Pecan Island. My buddy, Mr. Mouton, sent me some good reports. Now, Ryan Henry, Bennett, B.O., Stuart B.O., and Brett Davis, what they killed. They had hunted 2 days over there. First day, they hunted south of 82. They killed a lot of teal and a lot of things. And then Sunday, with all that wind and cold and sunshine, they did even better on the north side of 82. I got off the phone a while ago with Ryan Lambert. Okay, I've been wanting to talk to him. You know, Ryan and him have been disappointed the last couple of years. He had told me one time the second split is bad to find a, you know, don't have no water, get a north wind. Couldn't even get to the blinds. But let me tell you what, they ended up good the last day. There were a lot of ducks. He went across the bay, Grand Bay. He said that almost like the old days, the ducks were just getting up and blacking the sky, you know. But as soon as those mud boats start running, they go to the coast. And they didn't. Now, he said they killed, first day they killed 63, and then second day they killed 73, and they're six blinds. So they didn't do bad. It was better than it had been. He, like me, I always said against it because I had a pro drive and all them. We're going to have to do some restrictions on these mud boats because it's running the birds out. It's hard enough to find birds, but they're starting to run them away. When you finally got a few ducks and you start running them all day, don't just get in and get out, and need mufflers on some of these boats. So I think I solved that problem. I kept my pro drive boat, but I got a 115 Mercury and a jack plate on it right now. Ain't gonna be able to go in the mud, but when you got mud and you ain't no water, a lot of times you don't have ducks. So I guess next week I'm gonna give y'all a little bit more report and on the East Zone, because a lot of my friends and my brothers and all them hunting the East Zone. We'll give you a wrap-up on the East Zone next week. So when I come back, we got some more tournament reports.
I'm Brett Favre. As a quarterback in the NFL, if I didn't stay focused, I ended up on my back or worse. Even the smallest distraction could make a good play or offensive drive come to an end. When you're in a car, the smallest distraction could end much more than a drive. It could end someone's life. Just like I refuse to lose on the field, I refuse to lose someone I love to distracted driving. And you should too. Focus on the road. Don't drive distracted. A message from Farm Bureau Insurance.
The best part about being a member of a Touchstone Energy Cooperative is that it's your Touchstone Energy Cooperative. That's the power of your co-op membership.
DEMCO, your Touchstone Energy Cooperative.
Welcome back to BBQ, guys, and our Berkeley, Abu Garcia Fish Report. I'm going to start off with a tournament report. Excuse me. So a tournament report right now, we got one big tournament that came already started right now. That cold last past weekend. I'm talking about the Junior Southwest Bassmaster. So let me read these off for you pretty quick. They were fishing out of Bob Black. It's been a long time since they went out of Bob Black. And the 15 to 18 years old, first place was Hanson Cheney again out of Walker. He had 13.9. Second was that's Carson Granny from Brulee. And then Peyton Mathern from Walker was third. Big Bass was Hanson Cheney with 3.86. From 11 to 14 was Brady Talbot from Denham Springs with 15.70. You beat it to 15, yeah, that's a three-pound average. It's unbelievable. These kids are catching fish. Second was Caleb Robin from Denham Springs. And third was Jackson Rogers from Denham Springs. Big Bass was Brady Talbot with a 4.45. The reason I ain't giving them weight, because it's such a big difference. These guys fished out in that cold weather, and it was tough fishing. So, but they still, these kids are still producing, just like the big guys do. 7 to 10 years old, Anthony Tapia Jr. from Walker had 5.32. But like you said, they had three fish. Second was Mason Foster, and third was Branson McMillan, and he was also from Brulee. And the Big Bass was 2.48, so that was pretty good fish. Adults was John Booty Cheney at 13.90, Randall Robinson, Todd Rogers, and Big Bass was Doug Badron. Before I give you the Berkeley Abu Garcia Fishing Report, let me also say congratulations. I just got word, I didn't have it in written, that Louisiana Monroe won another the College Challenge again. I know they won it a couple times, so they won it again this year. I didn't have nothing and get it off of there, but you can go to thebassmasters.com and get it. They also got coming up the Bassmasters Kissimmee Open. It'll be Thursday and Friday coming up this week. And you can go and get a live broadcast of the weigh-in on Bassmasters.com. So just want to remind you of them, the national guys, the bass guys, they're fishing right now. Most time they go to Florida this time of year, but days like today, it's cold anywhere. So that was it. Now, in my little fishing report, I'm gonna tell you right now, I got to get this on. This young man here, Reed Watkins, he's fishing with his granddaddy, Ronnie Roserson, and look, 5.1 pounds bass caught on a brim hook with a piece of shrimp in Azalea Lakes, or in the lakes right there in the southeast part of the state. He's a Sacred Heart student. Congratulations to you and your grandfather. Beautiful fish, and he put it back. He put it back. They weighed it and put it back in the water. Catch and release, good dive. Toledo Bend, I want to give a little shout out. The Lake Country, right now they got their Holy Toledo properties in a lot of those places down there. They give a 20% discount on if you want to go to Toledo Bend. You know, February and March, there's a lot of those big over 10-pound fish caught. They call it the spree pond bite. So you go to Lake Country, go with them and book your trip. And if you got a camp, it's down to time to start going to Toledo Bend. You just got to watch those cold fronts and then be there. The Lodge right now, that's one of the places I keep getting fish. When it's cold, they go into them deep canals. They're fishing on the bottom with plastics. Rick Bailey and Leonard Atkins, and they have a Matrix Green Hornet on the bottom. And then if they get inside, it warms up. They put a cork on, and they fishing on the shallow water or the runouts. And they're catching a few bass, too, over there. Island Marina, well, you just saw with Perry Barras, they're fishing that whole area, fishing in what we call the Ponson Train. I showed y'all last week. I don't know if I showed y'all one of those pictures. I told you I had a lot of bass now, but Dudley had one picture in there. Maybe Chris can find it. It is unbelievable. Half the fish were bass. It was unbelievable when they're catching them on live shrimp and plastic, spinnerbaits, whatever. They're there on the edge of that grass Intercoastal Canal, Wrigley's, everywhere around there. I was catching those bass. Me and Perry were catching those bass right there in the Wrigley's in front of my nephew and my buddy's camp. So, then again, I told you, Mike Gallo, they fishing. All those guys in them are running down there. They not having a bad trip. They might not get on the trout, but what they fishing right now is constant. All the redfish you want, and they can find them bass about everywhere. The Pearl River, when we were there, was running pretty hard, but it's just they there. You all see the flounder they catching right now. Secret with flounder, you fishing gulp. You fish gulp, all our bait, but gulp is the best bait right now for flounder. Always have been. Yeah, I don't know what it is, but when they first hit it, let them take it. That's what the story is. And they're catching some beautiful flounder. They're over there and in Big Lake. That's the only report I got from Big Lake. They're having a little flounder run over there. So start sending me some more reports from there. Fishing me some north. I'm not getting any reports from Sakalay and them up north. But right now, that's about the only thing I got. Don't forget Island Marina. Miss Angie and them, boy, they're doing good. Bait Shop is over there with Miss Angie and them right now. So those guys that have moved over there, they moved away from Dockside. You can get all the shrimp you want. I think that's it. This is from Paradise, Louisiana. Don't forget BBQ. Guys, any kind of grill, any kind of outdoor furniture, anything you want, they got it. From tools to what you want to cook with, anything. They probably got wood chips, charcoal, whatever you want. You can cook with anything. Gas. Do listen to me. Come here. God bless Louisiana. And one more time, congratulations to LSU Tigers.
This is your weekly trip to paradise, Louisiana style, with Gary Risponi. Paradise, Louisiana is brought to you by Circle K, Baton Rouge Coca-Cola Bottling Company, Benny's Car Wash and Oil Change, Demco, CCA Louisiana, and the CCA Louisiana Star Tournament. Relief Windows, visit Baton Rouge, an authentic Louisiana experience. And by Farm Bureau Insurance.